Today, Waves announced the Curves EQ plugin. And according to Waves, now you never need to EQ again. And in the description, there's a link if you want to try this plugin out. And since I have water leakage in my studio, today I'm in my kitchen. But yeah, let's have a look at the plugin. And since I work mainly in live music, I will show you the live version of the plugin, but everything will work exactly the same in the studio. So let's load up the new Curves EQ Live plugin. And when you start things up, this is what it looks like. And in order to actually get it to work, we need to play some music and hit the learn button. And then the plugin will kind of analyze the signal coming in and make a overall EQ curve based on the signal coming in. So let's just play some guitar in this case and hit the learn button. And after a few seconds, the plugin suggests five different target curves that the plugin will try to get the incoming sound being as close to one of these target curves as possible. So let's have a listen, and let's actually start with everything in bypass. So this is what the guitar sounds without any processing at all. So I think this one is the closest to what I'm looking for. Let's hide all of these. And if you want to do this process over again, you can just open it up and start over. All right, so here's the target curve I selected for this guitar. So the plugin will do its best to get the guitar sounding as close as possible to this. Going down here, we have a static mode, which will, if we turn this back on, as you can see, everything is static. So if you just want a static EQ, this is what the plugin suggests. But then you have this slider, so you can go more and more to a dynamic way of working, and all the way to just using the dynamic section. And now the plugin will listen to the sound coming in and all of the time try to get it as close as possible to the target curve. I find that most of the time somewhere in the middle works the best. Right, moving on to the center of the plugin, you have this is the overall processing. So if we go down to zero, the plugin will not do anything, and then we can increase and have it be just wild and crazy. On the sides here, you have sliders for this is if you don't want the plugin to cut anything, you can go down on this slider. And let's go back up. And if you don't want the plugin to boost any frequencies, you just turn this one down. Then you have the tilt function, which is basically a normal tilt function. More high end, less low end, or the opposite. And you can, of course, slide the center frequency for this tilt. Then below the tilt, you have the offset, and this will basically move the tonality up or down in frequency. So these are the basic settings, but there's a lot more. So let's switch this one to a piano. So let's do the same thing. We get some piano and press the learn button. And the plugin identified this as a piano. So let's have a listen and see which one we like. So again, let's start in bypass. Thank you. So this is the one I think will work the best for this piano. So let's hide this one and let's look at some of the more advanced features within the plugin. So with the Curves EQ plugin, there's kind of a new way of approaching EQing or rather to sculpt sound. So if we press this little button, we get four different bands, call it. So we have the low, and for this source, the plugin has identified the low end of this piano to be 113 hertz. You can of course override this. You just slide this one up or down, and then you can get more or less of the low end. Then we have the fundamentals. Same thing, you can get more or less. You can change the target frequency. After the fundamentals, you have the harmonics. Same thing, move this up or down. And then you have the air. So let's actually have a listen to how this will change the sound. So that's one way of changing the overall sound with these four bands, but there's more. If you press this crossover, then you have these four bands, the low, fundamentals, the harmonics, and the air. These bands can be further manipulated as well. For each band, you can choose if you want this particular band to not boost anything. You just slide this one, or you want it to boost quite a lot. Same with the cut. If you don't, let's move to this one. If we don't want to cut as much over here, we just slide this one up and we have less of a cut in this area. So this you can do for all of the bands individually. But wait, there's more. There are, of course, high pass filter and low pass filter. And there's even more. If you find that these four bands are not enough, you need to be more precise. You can, of course, make your own custom EQ bands. This will be, well, not like a normal EQ, because you are still changing the target curve, not really the source. But this is more similar to a normal EQ. You can have a high or low shelf or a bell and change the curve. And you can have up to 8 of these bands. And if that wasn't enough, we have the advanced controls. So here you can change the attack of the dynamic section of the EQ and the release. You can also change the precision. So going from let's slide this so it only shows the dynamic side of it. So now it's a kind of a broadband type of EQ, and then you can go up to, I think it's 1,000 bands. So you can be really precise. So all of this can be a bit overwhelming when you get to the plugin for the first time. So what I've been doing is, let's reset this to the full reset. What I've been doing is hit the learn thing and just wait for it to do its thing. Then listen to the suggested options and just change the four bands if I need to. So let's have a listen, and you can see that you will get quite a good result quite fast. So within a few seconds, we go from a quite dull and boring piano sound to something that sounds bright and open. But wait, there's more. Let's go to the music group. So this is the group where all of the instruments end up, basically everything but vocals. And then I have sidechained the vocal group. So here I have the vocal group as a sidechain, and then you have the mix sense up here. So what this allows you to do is to remove frequencies of the music based on the frequencies of the vocals. So when the vocalist sings, you will remove some of the clashing frequencies in the music in order to have the vocal be kind of on top of the music. And for all of you working in live music, the big question is, of course, how much CPU does this eat up? So let's create a new project and see. All right, so here we have a new project with all of the processing happening on the B server. So right now it's at zero. So let's create a temporary link group here. Let's start with 10 instances of the curves AQ. And with 10 instances of this one, we go from 0 to 4%. But now the plugin is kind of in idle mode, so let's do some processing and see if the CPU usage changes. Yeah, and from what I can tell, there's no change in CPU usage, even if you use all of the features within the plugin. So, great. And as you can see, the live version of this plugin does not add any latency, which is just awesome. So, is this the game-changing plugin that will take EQ off the table and solve all of your problems? Well, not really. I really like the plugin, and I've been using it for a while, and I will absolutely keep using it, but it's another tool in the toolbox. I like, however, the way of thinking, that you move away from thinking in frequencies and more thinking in fundamentals and harmonics and air. So I think it's a nice way of working, but I mean, you're still EQing, you're just doing it in a new way. So please use the link in the description if you want to try this one out, and if you have any questions, let me know. All right, take care.